Good morning, and thank the chamber for inviting me here to talk today. How many veterans do we have here in the group today? If you could stand up, please stand up. I get emotional with veterans. Gentlemen, thank you so much for serving our country, because it's because you men and women, we are allowed to be here today to enjoy the freedoms that we have. And this country could not survive without the men and women who serve our country. So, a little bit about Honor Flight. It started in Ohio back in 2005 after the World War II Memorial was completed in 2004. Jim was working with some World War II vets, asking if they were going to be going down to Washington to see their memorial. And a year later, he's talking with them again. They hadn't been, so he rounded up 12 pilots and 6 planes and flew these World War II veterans down to Washington. After they were there, they saw a tremendous change in these World War II veterans. They got some final closure with what they went through. And slowly, it's made its way across the country. In 2012, my son went as a guardian for Kern County Honor Flight. And after he got home from his first flight, he called me up and said, hey, I need another $1,200 because I'm going to go on another one next month. So we got him the money. He went on his second one and came home and came over here to the Central Coast and started rounding up veterans. And we flew out of San Luis under the Kern County hub. In 2014, we decided to start our own hub here on the Central Coast. Since then, we've taken over 300 veterans at $1,500 a piece, and that money comes from grants and from the public. It takes us about $100,000 a year to take these veterans, and it's one of the greatest experiences that you will ever imagine. I went as a guardian. That's how I got started. I went for a World War II veteran that had 3 Purple Hearts, and after I went, it really changed my life. It really made me understand what these men and women do for us, and it's a small thing that we can give back to them and take them to Washington so they can get the closure that they need and the thank yous that they never got. Because when you talk to these men and women, they will tell you that they came home and got off the transport ship, and they either took a bus, a train, or a hitchhike back home, and went back to school or right back to work and built this country. And when Honor Flight started, it started with just World War II. Then it went to the Korean. Then it went to Vietnam guys. Now we are taking any veteran. It doesn't matter if you served during a wartime era. If you are a veteran and you chose to serve this country, you wrote a check, and we want to cash that check for you. We will take you back to Washington so you can see all these beautiful memorials that were built in your guys' honor, and let you honor the heroes that were left. Because when you talk to a veteran that's survived, he will tell you he's not the hero. The heroes were left behind and buried. But you are all heroes. And you need to understand that no matter what you did, whether you served during the wartime or you served in the States during the wartime, you still had a big impact on this country. It takes 20 non-combat veterans to support one combat veteran. Think about that. You had an impact on what went on, and without you, we would not be here enjoying San Luis Obispo, and we may not be here speaking the English. I just want to thank you so much, and I have some flyers over here. If you'd like to speak to me, I'll be hanging around. If you know a veteran, please have them get on our website, get signed up. We are willing to take them. Also, if you go to our website, you'll see a great 5-minute video. I know I have 5 minutes, and so I could talk about Honor Flight for hours, but I don't only have 5 minutes. So thank you so much, and have a great day.